Hey, Mal 31, I had a question on section 3.5, number 33. And the question was, write an equation for each of the functions you have graphed using transformations from one of the toolkit functions. So I think it's a good time to just remind you, when I talk about the toolkit functions, you can find those on page 174 of your book, all right? So they start on page 174. And what I would hope is that if you saw this graph right here, that basic V shape, that you would say, okay, I'm in the family of functions that's the absolute value of X. Because the absolute value of X, if we graphed it, it looks like this V, all right? So this is just a version. When I say this, I mean this thing that we have here. This is just a version of that function. So let's see how this was transformed. So on the original absolute value toolkit function, you would say, we might call that a vertex. It's not technically a parabola, but let's say that vertex is at 0, 0. Well, here, you can see that vertex is at 3, negative 2. So if we look at the x-coordinate, instead of it being 0 like it was on your toolkit function, it's been shifted right 3 units. And for this y value, right, instead of the y value being 0 like it is on the toolkit function, it's negative 2. So this has been shifted down 2 units. And how that affects your toolkit function is when you shift right, all right, inside of your grouping symbols, and when I say inside of the grouping symbols, I'm looking over here on my original toolkit function, the grouping symbol are the absolute value symbols. So inside those absolute value symbols, I'm going to have x minus 3 to shift me right. And then on the outside of those grouping symbols, I'm going to have a minus 2 to shift me down. And that's how we transform that equation, right? So I had my original, let me change the color here, my original toolkit function. And then if I want to shift it right 3 and down 2, there's my new equation. All right, thanks so much. Bye.